Well, thank you to the Rossmoor Homeowners Association for having this forum, and thank you to everyone who has who is attending here and online. My name is Jay Chen. I'm a Lieutenant Commander in the Navy Reserves, a community college trustee and a former school board member, and the father to two little boys, 6 years old and 8 years old. And I'm running for Congress in California's 45th Congressional District. I actually know the surrounding community pretty well. I was a drilling reservist at Los Alamitos Joint Forces Training Base for 8 years, and this is a wonderful community, and I'm really glad to be here. But I also need that you need good representation in Congress. I'm running for Congress because DC is broken, and we have far too many career politicians who are more interested in serving their special interests and their donors than serving the people who elected them. And one of the things I valued most about my service in the military is the fact that we don't discuss politics or party, we work together to accomplish the mission, and we need more of that in Washington, D.C. right now. And I was deployed to the Middle East in 2020 for Operation Inherent Resolve, the campaign to defeat ISIS, and I watched as the pandemic broke out, not just in the Middle East, but in the United States, and I watched how badly that was mishandled. And then upon my return home, I saw the insurrection, the attempt to undo the will of the people in Washington, D.C. I did not serve abroad to serve my nation, to come home to that kind of chaos, and that's one of the reasons why I'm running. I want to address several issues. Chief among them is inflation and getting our economy back on track, making sure that we enact sensible gun violence legislation, since I'm the father of two little boys, and the fact that we have active shooter drills completely appalls me. And also want to make sure that women continue to have the right to make their own healthcare decisions. Those are some of my priorities, and I look forward to meeting all of you and answering your questions. Thank you so much.
Good evening, Candidate Chen. I'm Gary Stewart from the RHA Board of Directors, and I'm going to be asking you your first question this evening. This year, there was a major nationwide redistricting effort aimed at serving our underrepresented populations and ethnicities. In fact, many of our existing district lines were shifted, and we now have both different boundaries and different representation. Would you speak to the issues of diversity and inclusion and give an example of how you plan to represent the many different needs and interests in our community?
Thank you for that question. And you're absolutely right. This is a brand new district. The Redistricting Commission, every 10 years, they redraw the lines. And a district like this has never existed before. This district is comprised of five previous congressional districts, and it stretches from Little Saigon and Rossmoor, Los Alamitos in the south, all the way up to Brea in the north. And this is actually a Asian plurality seat, or an Asian influence seat. The district is 37% Asian, 20% Latino. It's one of the most diverse districts in the country. And it's important that we have representatives who appreciate that diversity and can reach out in language, puedo hablar español y también yo puedo hablar chino. 我会说中文，我也会说西班牙语。我觉得这会讲不同的语言是非常非常的重要。 We need representatives who will embrace diversity and recognize that it is part of our strength. And as a part of that, even though I'm running for Congress right now, my campaign has been conducting citizenship workshops for the surrounding community. Anyone who wants to learn how to pass the citizenship test and become an American, they can come to our campaign office, and we're willing to spend the time and resources to teach them. So I definitely plan on continuing to be an advocate for the diverse communities in this district, regardless of where they come from, and I'll always be a voice for the underrepresented. Thank you.
Next question. Homelessness is a complicated issue and has become systematic in our society, affecting the mental health of those impacted. The social and cognitive ability of people without stable housing is exacerbated. What will you do to improve the availability of sustainable housing and ancillary services to minimize homelessness?
So homelessness is an issue that all cities and counties in California are currently grappling with. And the price of homes has simply skyrocketed to a point where it's become impossible for a young family to find a starter home. You know, starter homes are rapidly disappearing. There are a couple of reasons behind this. New homes are difficult to build because of the supply chain crisis. We have not completely recovered from the pandemic in terms of making our supply chains the way they were before the pandemic. So home building has become much more expensive. But we also have this phenomena of iBuyers, you know, internet companies like Zillow or Redfin or other companies that are gobbling up a lot of inventory, and also private equity companies that are now deriving much of their profits from buying single family homes and turning them into rentals. So the housing market has changed quite a bit because of the entrance of these much larger players. And as a federal representative, I want to make sure that we're keeping a close eye on this, because we know that when large companies make big bets and those bets go sour, usually it's the public that is left holding the bag with bailouts. We need to make sure that what's happening right now will not disrupt our economic system down the line. And also, I think that there are ways in which the federal government can alleviate the housing shortage by perhaps leasing, you know, lands, federal lands that are not being used. You know, even within cities and counties, the federal government has lands that could be put to use for housing. And also encouraging local governments through incentives to provide, you know, more streamlined ways for people to build homes for those who need them.
Candidate Chen, our next question is about taxes. Many taxes in California on such things as gasoline, income, sales are amongst the highest in the nation. Yet at the end of 2017, a tax act was passed by Congress that limited the deductibility of state and local taxes, also known as SALT, to California residents. What is your position on the limitation that's imposed by that law?
So the SALT cap was part of a larger tax package in 2017 that was really designed to benefit the wealthiest, those who are in least need of that kind of tax relief. And in addition to those tax cuts for billionaires, there was a SALT cap that was designed to basically punish those who lived on in the coastal states, in New York and in California, folks who actually pay pretty high state taxes already. And in Orange County, the median price of a home is now over $1 million. So when you have a SALT deduction cap of $10,000, your property tax already exceeds that. So this was a punitive measure, and I fully support raising or eliminating that SALT cap, bringing back to where it was. And I'm disappointed that my opponent, despite having an opportunity to address that issue, has not done that. I think that is one of the most punitive measures that have been enacted, and it's something that I fully stand behind in terms of either repealing or raising.
Fourth question and final question. Do you believe the government has a right to dictate or to limit a woman's health care choices, including childbirth?
I am horrified that little girls today have fewer rights than what their grandmothers grew up with. And the repeal of Roe v. Wade was an absolute mistake. And I am beyond disappointed that Michelle Steele signed the amicus brief to overturn Roe v. Wade and later on co-sponsored a bill called Life at Conception Act, which would make abortion illegal. It would create a federal ban on abortion without any exceptions. And I wish that she was here to actually explain her vote, her decision to back that bill. The right for a woman to make her own healthcare decisions should be absolute. And we need to get government out of these very, very personal decisions. And I would fully support bringing back Roe v. Wade, codifying it through federal legislation. And we have to know that here in California, even though we have state laws that may protect us, if they pass a federal ban, that will override whatever state protections we have. So when representatives claim, well, it's just a state issue, and a federal ban is just a hypothetical, it's only hypothetical until you vote on it, and then it's no longer a state issue. And my opponent has made clear her stance on a federal ban on abortion without exceptions. That's what she wants, and we need to stop that.
Candidate Chen, thank you for your answers. You now have 2 minutes to sum up your presentation and give the folks of this district reasons to vote for you.
Well, thank you again to the Rossmoor Homeowners Association for holding this event, and to everyone who has attended, and also to the candidates. I saw Kim Carr, Deirdre Tuha Nguyen. You know, it's difficult running for office. There are a lot of demands on your time, but there's nothing more important than these types of forums where the voters get an up-close and personal chance to meet you. And I think it's really telling who chose to show up and who chose to stay home, who refuses to engage with the public and hides behind scripted events and refuses to answer questions. So I hope that all voters will take into account who actually values democracy. And the fact is, in this election, democracy is on the line. We saw what happened on January 6th with those attacks, and it's important that we elect individuals who actually understand what that oath to the Constitution means. I took that oath not just as a community college board member or as a school board member, but I took an oath to defend the Constitution as an officer in the U.S. Navy Reserves. And it's not an oath to defend a political party or any individual. It's an oath to defend the Constitution. We need people who really understand that. And no matter what happens in this election, I want you to know that I'm going to be your representative. My hope is that people do not just make or cast their votes based on political party, but they'll actually take a look at what these individuals have done and what they plan to do. And we have so much that we need to address that we cannot have folks in office who are simply going to be voting no or opposing things just to make a political point. We need folks who are willing to move our community forward, and there isn't a community that's more engaged than Rossmoor. So I really want to thank everyone for being here and giving everyone an opportunity for the Rossmoor Homeowners Association, giving everyone an opportunity to hear about my candidacy and the candidacy of everyone else who respects you enough to show up. Thank you so much.